Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Fanboys, be advised, this video contains the absolute truth, may cause hurt feelings, and a need to thumbs down the video. It's official, Tim Bradley is a Canelo Alvarez hater, and let's just break down his statement. Tim Bradley states Canelo is not facing the best right now. Here's his exact statement. He states, the only problem I have with Canelo Alvarez is he's not facing the best guys right now. He's winning these belts, challenging guys in different weight classes. You have to fight a guy at 168 in David Benavidez who wants all the smoke, but Canelo won't fight him. You have a guy in Jermall Charlo who would probably be willing to go up to fight Canelo. There's always talk about how these guys don't really want to fight, or how the money isn't right, or how they haven't fought enough names to be worthy of a shot, but come on, stop it. It's just a way to avoid a fighter in a fight you don't want. So, you know, in essence, Tim the Hater Bradley is saying Canelo Alvarez doesn't want to fight Jermall Charlo. Canelo Alvarez doesn't want to fight David Benavidez, and he's not facing the best. But then how in the hell is he winning these belts, Tim? Tim the dummy Bradley, Tim the idiot Bradley, Tim the moron Bradley, Tim the company man Bradley. Let's break it down. Facts from feelings. Canelo Alvarez just fought the number one fighter at 168 pounds. The guy won the World Boxing Super Series. He had an enormous height and reach advantage. He was undefeated and in his prime. He was the ranked champion and WBA champion, and Canelo Alvarez was able to unify the WBC as well with those belts against this guy. He was the consensus number one fighter at 168. And you say he's fighting nobody? He's not fighting the best. He just fought the best, you stupid, idiot, moron, dummy. And then you want to bring up David Benavidez like that's something. Look, why is Canelo not facing David Benavidez? Because he's not a champion, you moron. David Benavidez lost his belt on the scale because he came in overweight. That's why they named him Chips and Queso Benavidez. That's how he got the nickname. That's it, you idiot. The guy gave up his belt. Why would Canelo avoid a world champion and becoming the number one fighter in the division to face a guy with no belt? Does that make any sense, you idiot? It does not. Not only that, to say that Canelo Alvarez is ducking David Benavidez is even more comical, because David Benavidez has said before and after he was champion, he came out and stated that he does not want to face Canelo Alvarez next. He wants to face Caleb Plant. He would prefer to face Caleb Plant than to face Canelo Alvarez. That's avoiding the smoke. That's delaying the smoke. Canelo Alvarez says he wants all the champions in the division, no matter who has the belt. So if David Benavidez and Caleb Plant are on the same network, then get the fight done so Canelo can face the winner. It's not Canelo's fault that David Benavidez is not disciplined. It's not Canelo's fault that David Benavidez can't stay out of the chips and queso. Why you got Tim Bradley over here sucking off these guys with no facts or proof? But let's just keep it going. Not only does David Benavidez not want to smoke with Canelo right away because he really prefers Caleb Plant, but you turn your attention to Jermall Charlo. Jermall Charlo has already rejected a fight with Canelo Alvarez. So that kills your whole bias argument. Not only did he reject the fight, his own brother ripped him apart by confirming what we know to be the truth, saying he would never turn down a Canelo Alvarez fight. So at the end of the day, we know Jermall Charlo is ducked it. We know he turned down the fight. We know the truth. So explain to me this, Tim the Hater Bradley, Tim the Idiot Bradley, Tim the Dummy Bradley. How can Canelo Alvarez fight guys who don't want to fight him? Charlo rejected an offer, and David Benavidez said before and after he was a champion, he didn't want to face Canelo next. He wants Caleb Plant more than any other fighter. You can't fight guys who don't want to fight you. And why would Canelo Alvarez even want to fight these guys at this moment? Neither of these guys have a belt at 168 pounds, you idiot. That's where he's fighting. Of course he's going to fight the number one undefeated world champion in the weight class and become the best fighter at 168. This guy got to be delusional or stupid. See, these are facts that can be proven. These guys are full of trash. And look, let's just keep it going about Tim the Hater Bradley. We know he's been a Canelo Alvarez hater. And let me explain this. He came out and stated that Canelo doesn't want it with Arthur Better BF. Why in the hell would Canelo Alvarez be looking for a fight with Arthur Better BF when Canelo Alvarez and his trainer clearly stated their plan is to fight at 60 and 68? They are not campaigning at 175 pounds. That is not their weight. They both said this many times, but you're saying he doesn't want it with a fighter in a division that he does not campaign in. That is a hater, let's be honest. And not only that, you get Tim Bradley over here sucking off Terrence Crawford every single day for facing a washed up garbage truck juice fighter in Kell Brook at this point in his career, but yet no one says anything about this. Tim Bradley came out and said, as Terrence Crawford looks good in there against Kell Brook, he's going to earn a lot of people's respect, because anybody counting out Kell Brook, saying he's washed and all that, they don't know shit about boxing. I'm letting you know that right now. Well, the problem I have with that is, what did Bomax say about Kell Brook? What did he say? He said this man is a wounded duck. That's Terrence Crawford's own trainer. Terrence Crawford's own trainer said that this isn't the same Kell Brook that Sean Porter fought. He said this isn't the same Kell Brook. He's been beat up multiple times and stopped multiple times. This is a washed Kell Brook who hadn't even fought at 147 in over 3 years. So at the end of the day, this guy is garbage truck juice, a hater. And remember, men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.